I'm in one of Taipei's largest household registration offices, which has made history by completing the adoption of a child by a same-sex couple. It's been a long journey for Miao Miao and Wei Wei. They sued the government to recognize both men as parents of Wei Wei's adopted daughter after they married. But the court ruling only applied to their case. It did not set a legal precedent. So for now, it is just this one couple that can celebrate this latest LGBT milestone.
终于这一刻终于到了，就是我很期待等一下，我小孩的身份证上面能够出现我的名字，对吧？终于到了这一步，觉得很开心，然后觉得也很，一未来也很辛苦，对，然后虽然说很为我们自己的案件开心，但是呢，因为我们知道说我们还有其他一样无血缘收养的家庭。
In 2019, Taiwan became the first country in Asia to allow same-sex couples to marry, and is often heralded as a beacon of liberalism, hosting the largest LGBT pride event in Asia. But the marriage legislation fell short of granting equal marriage rights, including the right to joint adoption, which is only allowed when the child is biologically related to one of the parents. Under Taiwan law, opposite-sex couples and single people are allowed to adopt.
我们不应该让儿童的权利因为行政机关的怠惰或是持续严厉而有所损害，也更不应该让想要收养的同志家庭为了要收养，为了这个严厉中而必须离婚才有办法去帮助更多的家庭。我们希望呼吁法务部能够尽快修法，不要再让这件事情持续延宕。
此法已判准，立法请跟上。
Miao Miao, Wei Wei, and their daughter are now officially a family, but many other couples like them are denied this opportunity. It's a reminder that despite its successes, Taiwan is still on the road to true LGBT equality. Patrick Chen and Rick Glauert for TaiwanPlus.